Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to Ringwoods. We are right here at the compost bunker. We just filled the bunker again. We are at the moment just at 1% on the fermenting stage. So we have done that. We moved some straws from our silo because the compost that we had. Let me get out of the rain into the truck and let me show you. We have sold all the compost that was in that bunker and we got 315,877 dollars, which is really good. And before we did that, we took a loan from the bank to buy field one. Now we own it, it's ours. We did manage to spray some lime on it, so let's see. This is as much as we been able to do so far. Anyway, we're gonna finish spraying lime, and if you can look at field 22 and field 2, now it looks like a big field. I just went ahead and plow under all this grass, created a field between these two fields right here. So now we're looking at just one big field. We'll call this one field 222. So yeah, and like I said, we need to keep on working on field one, but first, before we do that, let's pay back the entire loan that we still have left. Like I said, we did took $300,000 on a loan, so we were able to buy that field. And it's raining outside, not much to do. Obviously, we can forget about any harvesting contracts because we're not going to be able to do any of that. Not that many contracts, not that many fields that we can harvest anyway that are still left. Let me park right here. Not the best place to park our truck, but anyway. Let me take a look real quick. Growth. Okay. Growth menu and looking like field 23, 12, 26, 7, and field 10 are still on a harvesting stage. But with the rain, obviously, we're not going to be able to get on that. And in the contract menu, there's only field 26 that is available on a contract for harvesting, only paying 3,000, and I'm not gonna get even worry about that contract. We just accepted this contract on field 6 fertilizing job. And yes, I know it feels like everything we do, or most of the things we do on this map, are fertilizing contracts, but they are paying good money and we need money. As soon as we're gonna get more and more fields, that's the time when we're gonna need more and more equipment. So we are gonna need a lot of money moving forward, obviously. But this is field 6 right in front of us, so let's start to unfold our sprayer. I did mounted the GPS on this sprayer, so now we can use it. It makes sense, we are using the sprayer quite often, so no point in not having GPS. Let's see if I can bring, I'll bring the line as well, why not? But I wanna see if I can load that course. Yep, and it worked. Let me fix my position just for a little bit and then fix the GPS on where I want it, where we are. Is it gonna work? Yeah, it did work. So let's get on the harvesting. On the spraying part, on the contract, we are using the have a look. 85 liters per hectares of liquid fertilizer. Not that bad. It's pretty decent, I think. Let's also get rid of the lines so they're not in the way. And looking at the weather, to be honest, it looks like we're only gonna have bad weather from now on. Thursday, so that's today is Wednesday, so tomorrow's Thursday, and it looks like we're gonna have rain until 3 in the morning. So everything, even tomorrow, it's still gonna be wet. I'm not sure if there's gonna be any harvesting job that it's gonna pay this some money. I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to do that. So we need to think twice before accepting a harvesting contract. And then Thursday at noon, it's gonna start raining again. And then probably the entire night, the entire day, Friday, Saturday, it looks like we're gonna have some snow. Monday and Tuesday is just as well, snow. So Sunday is pretty much the only day where there's not gonna be having anything dropping from the sky. So that's pretty much gonna do it for any harvesting contract that we will consider doing, or any contract that we could have started doing. So we're not gonna do any of the contracts that, even if there gonna be any contracts showing up, we're not gonna get on those. I'm not sure that we're gonna be able to finish and we're gonna fail, and that's gonna be time we're wasting and diesel that we're wasting, and I'm not gonna do that. Looks like pretty much everything we're gonna do until ground is gonna be frozen and we can't even gonna be able to do that is actually do some field work on our own fields. Not that we need much field work on our fields. Everything is set already. All we need to do is just spraying some lime, and that's pretty much it. So we're not looking bad. We're looking pretty decent in terms of our own fields. As you guys can see, everything is cultivated. We're gonna wait until springtime, and then we're gonna plant some crops. Most of the crops we can in fact start planting, but we're not gonna do that just yet. And in terms of field one, looks like we finished the contract on this field. Let's just finish the field entirely. We're not that further away from the headland, so let's make sure we finish. Alright, so we changed the equipment. We left the sprayer back at the farm in one of the sheds. We jumped into our Fendt tractor, and now we are spraying lime on field one. We're gonna finish field one, obviously not much, not long until we finish, and then we're gonna move over to field 22, well, field 222, and then field 21. We're gonna finish spraying lime on those fields. And that's pretty much what we're gonna be able to do with the rain that we're having. Let's see. Looks like one more day for harvesting season. So some of the crops, three more days, or some other crops. But like I was showing you guys earlier, not those many crops that, not those many fields that are still left to harvest. So that means that we're pretty much gonna enjoy the time, spending most of the times back at the house, just relaxing, enjoying, watching some TV and all the good stuff, and forget all about the field work. As soon as we spray lime on all of our fields, that's gonna be it, at least for the fields that we own. Nothing else we are gonna need to do until planting season and springtime. So there's that. I went way too far from the corner of the field. Let's go back. Can never go the way I want to with this sprayer. I don't know why. And let's show the line in GPS first, because I want to see how bad we're looking, and obviously we're looking really bad. Let's see if I can get them all better. Alright, so now let's move everything over to the right. Should be good enough. It is looking good. And now let's head on over and finish spraying lime on all of our fields. Obviously this is gonna take a while, it's gonna take quite some time. We're not spraying, we're not using that much lime. We're spraying at 0.73 tons per hectare. Obviously we already sprayed lime once when we first started playing on the map. And obviously, as you guys saw, field 2 was not looking as bad as field 1 was looking previously, but now it looks like what field 1 is looking after we sprayed lime on the entire field. But what do you guys say? We have a quick time lapse, and I'll see you guys when we are finished. Okay, and we are back. Man, this is gonna take a long time. We barely finished field 2 and now we are in the middle of the part that was in between the two fields, and obviously it's not showing up on the precision farming menu because precision farming doesn't see the field that you're creating as part of the fields that came with the map. So there's that, and this is gonna be an issue every time we're gonna do this, but it doesn't matter. We're spraying, it looks like with still 0.73 tons per hectare, and that's what we were spraying on field 2. So it's not any kind of difference between the actual field and the field that we've just created. I want to fix this tiny spot here. I know I probably shouldn't, but I cannot leave it just like that. And now we are pretty much, I think, going into field 22. Well, before we do that, let's just fold our sprayer and let's just refill so we don't run out of lime in the middle of the field. We're just gonna refill with lime and then we are gonna go back and finish spraying lime on all of our fields. And we are back into the fields. We are back in field 22 now. And let's take a look. We're looking good on pH value into the fields. Looking good on field 1, 2, and we just started spraying lime on field 22. Then once we are done with field 22, we're gonna move over to field 21. We're gonna spray lime on that field and we're pretty much with field work for the entire year. We are not gonna have anything to worry about in terms of field work until planting season that starts in the spring. Well, starts for us anyway, because as you guys know already, you can on this geo at least, let me bring the season menu, you can pretty much plant in the fall as well, which at least for wheat, barley and oat it's the case, and even canola it's the case in most countries, but probably or maybe not every country, it depends pretty much on where you are from. But some countries, including the one that I live in, on fall time, it's planting season for some of the crops that I just said. If you wait for the springtime, you might miss the window and all these cereals, as we call them, they're not gonna be ready if you don't plant them in fall. Corn is a different matter, that's planted in spring. So we're not talking about corn, talking about wheat, barley, oats, canola. Not sure about soybeans, to be honest, but doesn't matter. I'm not even a farmer in real life, so like I said, not really important. But we are, I think, halfway. Well, I need to go into precision farming menu to take a look, see how well we're doing. I'm pretty sure we are almost halfway done with field 22, so it's not that long now. Let's take a look at the application rate. 0.36 or 0.73, so it's changing. I'm guessing it depends on the soil, maybe, probably, I don't know, maybe, but not long for us to go until we finish field 22. And then all we have to worry about is field 21. And I think I forgot to get the money for the contract we finished. Not sure, let us check. Yeah, fertilizing field 6, $12,012. So let's get paid. Not gonna worry about any of these contracts that we have left, so not really worth it. We're looking at $67,084. Let's make sure. Yeah, we did pay the entire loan, so nothing to worry about. Now, for now, we need to worry about this part of the field work and then wait for a day or two or until the compost is gonna be fermented at 100%, sell the compost, get more money and see what we're gonna be able to do with the money. So what do you guys say? You let me finish this field work and I'll see you when I'm done. And we are back, and it's early winter, day one. Everything is covered in snow. We kind of expected everything be like this because we did check the weather and those were the signs. And driving this truck on this snow with fully loaded, it's gonna be pretty fun. This truck almost have no brakes on dry asphalt on the road covered in snow. It's gonna be, like I said, even more fun to drive. But we're heading over to Freedom Mill. That's where we get the best price for the compost at the moment. So that's where we're gonna be heading and sell the compost. We're gonna see how much we're getting. The price is at the moment $929. It's going up, so we're hopefully gonna get better price. But we're driving this first load at the sell point, see how much we're getting. I don't expect that the price will go that much higher, to be honest, but it doesn't matter. It's not a bad price still. Even 929, it's obviously not a bad price at all. And we are almost at the sell point, and I'm just curious how much you're gonna make out of all the compost. Let's see how we are gonna find the sell point. Let's take a look. Yep. Oops. Going a bit too fast right there on the turn. And here we are. Let's see how much we're gonna make out of 120,000 liters of compost. Just curious about that. Looking pretty good, to be honest. So let's see. 111,568 dollars, which is really good. And we should be, oops, yep, just sliding a little bit onto the right right there. But actually the trailer was not really the truck, but the truck, it's not gonna do any better if we don't watch our speed. Yeah, so we should have two more loads of compost that we need to sell. So that will mean we're gonna be making just a little bit over 300,000 out of the compost alone. And we still have in our silo, let's take a look real quick, 366,000 liters of straws. That's pretty much three more loads that we can turn into compost, and we probably should be doing that. It's gonna bring us a lot of money, and that would get us to be able to afford to buy a new field. So that's what we're gonna do next. I forgot what crops. All right, I need to slow down. I was saying that I forgot what crops we're having for the next year on our fields. So let's take a look real quick while we're loading. So we're gonna have canola on field 222 and field 1, and sorghum on field 21. I think that's how I've made it. I have no idea. Let's see if I can see that from the fields. It's gonna take a little bit of jogging into the field. So previous oil seed, no, there's no way we had on field two oil seed. No, it's not gonna show me. Cereal, okay. Yeah, maybe. I think the way I had them was field 21 was canola. Nope, field 21 was oat, so that means we're gonna have canola on that field next. That's gonna drop straws, that's gonna turn into compost, that's gonna bring us a whole lot of money. Sorghum we're gonna have on field 222, and on field 1 that drops straws, that will be turned into compost, and in return that is also gonna bring us a lot of money. So everything is working out great for us. We are completely full, have one full load, started the truck. Let's get into the belt and move it over to the compost so it will not start picking up snow. All the snow that I moved from this place into here, in between the bunkers, I used the belt to move that snow. And one more load into the sell point. Let's take a look at the price before I crash into anything, hopefully. Okay, so let me just go into the main road right here. Makes it better for me to look in the menus while driving on a straight line. $930, still going higher, but like I said, I don't think it will go that higher. No reason to wait for maybe just a dollar more. We're making really decent money out of the compost, and let me break because I'm going to crash into that truck. They don't stop under no circumstances, so you need to check for traffic. But anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, please consider subscribing. It will help the channel grow. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all next time.